lonely, disappointed father. Rejected ruler of the universe. Handsome, jealous lord and lover. Angry, wrinkled old majesty. I want to pray. I want to say Kaddish. Listen, Almighty, with all your might. There may just be no one to say it after me. I have your attention, majestic father. Is my end a minute away? An hour? Is there even time to ask the question? It could be here while we are singing that we're to be halted once for all, cut off in the act of praising you. But while I have breath, however briefly, I will sing this final Kaddish for you, for me, for all these I love here in this sacred house. Pray, and time is short. Time to begin our gallant Yit Gadal. Magnified. And sanctified, be the great name, Amen.
We'll be right back.
abundant peace descend on us, amen. Great God, surely you who make peace on high, who manipulate clumsy galaxies, you who juggle a space full of suns, bend light, spin moons, surely you can handily supply a touch of order here below, on this one dazed speck. And let us say again, amen. Amen on my lips, I approach your presence, Father, not with fear, but with a certain respectful fury. I have very little time, as you well know. Do you recognize my voice? Must I reintroduce myself? Ani Chavatzelet Hasharon, Shoshanat HaAmakim. I am the Lily of Sharon, the Rose of the Valleys, daughter of Zion. I am that part of man you made to suggest his immortality. You surely remember, Father, the part that refuses death, that insists on you, divesses your grace. And always you have heard my voice. Always you have saluted me, even a plague, something. But now I see nothing. This time you show me nothing at all. Father, understand what is happening. I am exiled by man, no longer cherished, while he runs free, free to play with his newfound fire, avid for death, voluptuous, total, and ultimate death. Lord God of hosts, I call you to account, and don't shrug me off as if I were playing defiant daughter, your impudent rebel who could do with a slap. You know who I am. Ani Chavatzelet Hasharon, the lily that man has picked and thrown away. And you let this happen, Lord of hosts. You with your mana, your pillar of fire. You ask for faith. Where is your own? Why have you taken away your rainbow, that pretty bow you tied round your finger to remind you never to forget your promise? Shall I quote you your own weighty words? For lo, I do set my bow in the cloud, and I will look upon it that I may remember my everlasting covenant. Your covenant, your bargain with man, tin! God, your bargain is tin. It crumples in my hand. And where is faith now? Yours or mine? Forgive me, Father. I was mad with fever. Chaos is catching and I succumbed. Have I hurt you, Father? Forgive me. In fever, I forgot you too are vulnerable. If my faith is shaky, what must yours be? But yours was the first fatal mistake, creating man in your own image, fallible. Dear God, how you must suffer. So far away, ruefully eyeing your two-footed handiwork, frail, foolish, mortal. My sorrowful Father, if I could comfort you, hold you against me, rock you and rock you into sleep. Shall I sing to you? Shall I tell you stories of other stars? Stars that you love, that deserve your love. Stars that do not disappoint and disgust and disgrace your love. Oh, I hope they exist for your sake, Father. My heart's pity boils in my throat. I can barely speak. Be comforted. Be magnified, sanctified.